boys and girls.
For my own mental sanity, I decided to get out of the house today, in the morning at least. Just I've been really working hard, like school, just finishing up. I'm also on YouTube videos and on obviously videos for my job as well. I just needed to do something different, and it's a little bit more entertaining to see me actually get out of my room talking about video and crap like that. We did film the podcast yesterday, so that was fun. It went really well, and I sure hope you guys tune in. I'm gonna play the intro right now, maybe a little snippet if Rich can get a little bit over to us. Welcome everyone to the inaugural episode of the Second Perspective podcast. My name is Pete. And I make pretty terrible YouTube videos. That's my background. And I'm here with my colleague, friend, thousands of miles away across the pond, Rich Heaney. Rich?
How we doing, everyone? Like Pete said, welcome. The first ever podcast.
What we're going to do is alternate the edit. So he's editing it this week. I'm going to edit next week. I made the intro. He made some of the graphics. He made basically all the graphics. And like I said, it's going to be up on Spotify and Apple Music, not on Sunday, but the episode will come out on SoundCloud and YouTube on Sunday, just to preface that, but I hope you guys enjoy it. Like I said, I've just been kind of overworking myself, if that means, if that makes sense. So it's good to get out here and just kind of take it easy today, I guess. Videography tip for this episode. A lot of videographers especially underestimate the power of the phone when making videos or films or taking photos, whatever it be. I'm here to tell you this is the most convenient tool you'll have. Just being able to not worry about settings or anything and just flip out your phone and take a quick video, take a quick little snippet, whatever it be. It's gonna sound super cliche. The most powerful camera you have is the one on you. And sometimes, like in that intro when I was walking out here, it was just easier for me to flip my phone out in that tight space with all the plants. I mean, I use my phone a lot and it's got a cracked back, you can't see it. Had it for a year and a half. It's like an XS Max and it's nice, but it's not got the wide angles or like anything that the 11 Pro has. So use what tools you have at your disposal. I know that's cliche and everyone says it, but that's my tip for today. And I use my phone quite a bit. One of my favorite and also least favorite things about having a YouTube channel and uploading regularly is that my audience can kind of hold me accountable. And why it's my least and most favorite thing is that I can say that I'm doing something and I have to stick to it. I mean, I don't have to, but like that's kind of my interior motive, I guess, like internal motive. It's good in a way where I can say like, hey, I'm doing this and I can achieve that goal. But also like, I say I'm uploading a video one day and then I don't really feel like it when that, day comes. That's where it gets bad. But I like doing them, so I keep doing them. But you guys are gonna hold me accountable for this week and my running total. I'm gonna try and hit 17 miles. I'm at 2.5 right now and it's Tuesday. I ran 16.5 miles last week, so we should be able to hit it. La, 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 la. I can feel your energy a mile away. I feel your energy from outer space. About 3 miles. Overall, pretty good run. This vlog's been all about just like getting outside. Honestly, it's been good for me. The soccer in the morning and then a little bit of this today. I got something special for the end of this vlog, so please stay tuned. I mentioned the last video, but... Ladies and gentlemen, the moment you've all been waiting for in this vlog. I know. I teased it in the last vlog. I said there'd be something special. And we've done some pretty weird things on this vlog, like played beer pong with eggs. I had a friend jump off a porch. Twice, actually. We made a diss track about a dog. That was weird. Video didn't do very well. And then I played Keepy Uppies with some toilet paper. That was in quarantine more recently. But quarantine calls for desperate measures. So today, I'm going to... As inspired by Cody Ko, I saw him follow along with a Bob Ross painting on Photoshop. I am going to create a world famous piece of art, and not just any world famous piece of art, the Mona Lisa, the crown jewel of art. So, with that being said, let's fire up Google here and then type in the Mona Lisa as inspiration. What do we got here? Seems simple enough, not that great detail. Ah, yes, I love my Wi-Fi, it's so fast. I'm just gonna say this before this all begins, before I open Photoshop. This is going to be terrible, and this is just me filling time, but I think it's going to be funny. Let's do the best we can. All right, Photoshop it is.
Let's get to it, baby. Woohoo!
Okay, so I'm going to draw the background first. Like, we got a solid brown. Wow, I'm... Good start, boys. Nice earthy brown here. All right, now we need to add some detail. Charcoal pencil. Pastel Palooza. I don't know how to use any of these brushes. We got a good start. This is gonna be so bad. Oh yeah, baby. All right, and that's just the beginning. So, gotta paint the rest of this. Looks like we got a little swirly road. This is so hard. Who even was Mona Lisa? I need to look this up so I'm like cultured, you know? This is such a terrible brush. Whose idea was this? All right. Focus. That's a little too green, but whatever, that's what's gonna happen. That's not bad. Not bad at all. All right, the mountains are gonna be the really hard part here. I regret doing this. God dang it, this is so hard. Holy this is so hard. Gosh dang it. All right, Lisa. Lisa's kind of good looking, not gonna lie. These are not mountains at all. These do not look like mountains. Oh my gosh. Oh my God. What did I do? Stop! Nope. I got an idea. Let's make these jagged so they look more like mountains. Oh yeah, baby. Oh yeah, let's go. I should never make a YouTube video again. Now we got our spot for Lisa. Let's just fill this in with a color, cause whatever. Cause this already is so bad that it doesn't matter. I don't know if Lisa's ready to see what she looks like. I heard this was her bad side. That's what the color we're looking for. I feel like I'm in art class or something. This is definitely what mine looked like in third grade. Just terrible. I'm not giving up. Mark my words, I'm not giving up. Oh yeah, baby, let's go. Oh my God. Now we need to do her clothes, and I think we're about done. So we got a little bit of a robe action here. I'm gonna tell you what I'm gonna do right here. Circle with hand emoji. Copy, paste, because I don't know how to make a hand. She's only gonna have one hand, so. Just a heads up, we're gonna draw this part of her arm. Yo, she looking kinda good though. All right, let's add a little black detailing. All right, boys and girls, my version of the Mona Lisa on Photoshop. This is gonna sell for quintillion V-Bucks on Fortnite.
Look at that, beautiful. Look at that, uncanny.
Alright guys and girls, I hope you found that a little bit fun. It was really much harder than I thought. It was fun nonetheless, and I think it provided some laughs. So if you enjoyed, like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next upload. I might take a break this weekend because I have an idea for like a film. Like a short film that from like old clips that I've put together. But yeah, like and subscribe. See you guys. Candy.